Hello students, this lecture is about Streptococcus pneumoniae. There are a number of viruses and bacteria which can cause pneumonia. Among these, Streptococcus pneumoniae is the most prevalent causative agent for pneumonia. As it causes pneumonia, it is commonly called pneumococcus. It has one more name, Diplococcus pneumoniae. The bacteria is present as the normal microflora of nasopharynx in the healthy individual, causes pneumonia and otitis media in the two extreme groups, which are the children and aged individuals. In addition to the pneumonia, it can also cause sinusitis, bronchitis, bacteremia and meningitis. The children having the sickle cell anemia, they are having the more chances to get the infection. There is a milestone in the history associated with pneumococcus. First isolated by Louis Pasteur. Then I think you might remember the experiment of Griffith, who used the rough and smooth strains of this bacteria and proved that DNA is genetic material. He carried out the experiments which were termed transformation. Now, how does this bacteria looks like? The bacterium is spherical, that means these are cocci, but they are not perfect cocci. You can see that one end is pointed, the other end is broad. Two cocci, they form a pair, so it is called diplococci. Each pair is enclosed by a refractile layer. This is called the capsule. This capsule is also antigenic in nature, made up of polysaccharide. The appearance of the cocci is called the flame or the lanceolate appearance. The bacteria is non-motile, it does not form the spores. The biochemical characteristics, some are unique because of which we can differentiate it from other streptococci. It ferments a number of sugars, fermentation is tested in the his serum. The inulin sugar is fermented only by this bacteria, not by other streptococci. The biosolubility test is one characteristic test of S. pneumoniae. The biosalt, 10% sodium deoxycholate, when added to the overnight broth culture, the culture becomes clear. It can also be carried out on a colony. The colony lyses when the salt is added. This activity is because of the enzyme amidase, which cleaves the bond between the aniline and murmuric acid in peptidoglycan. The organism is both catalase and oxidase negative, sensitive to sulfonamides and number of antibiotics. Another characteristic biochemical is the autosin, 1:5 concentration of ethyl hydrocuprine, also called optosin, is used to carry out a sensitivity test. S. pneumoniae is optosin sensitive, while other streptococci, they are resistant. Among the culture characteristics, the organism is fastidious. It grows only in the blood agar and the chocolate agar. The organism is aerobe and facultative anaerobe. Optimum temperature 37 degrees Celsius. The optimum pH is 7.8. Growth is better when the 5% to 10% CO2 environment is used. The colonies, they are smaller on the blood agar, which becomes green in color due to the alpha hemolysis. On further incubation, the colonies are flat with depressed center. The edges are raised. This appearance is called the snake-headed, the draftsman, or the carancoin appearance. The organism possesses a number of antigens in the capsule and in the cell wall. Capsular antigen, also called the triple S substance. The C carbohydrate antigen in the cell wall. Lipoteichoic acid, also known as Forssman antigen. M protein is also there. In the case of virulence factor, the most important is pili, because of which the bacteria attaches to the epithelial cells of respiratory tract. It produces nemolysin, which is a pore-forming toxin. It causes the cytolytic activity of the respiratory epithelial cells, hence the damage to the respiratory tract of the host. It also activates the complement and produces the C3b. The organism produces hemolysin, leukocytin. The capsular polysaccharide is also anti-phagocytic in nature. Another special virulence characteristic which this organism produces is the IgA protease. IgA is the immunity which is present at the mucosal level. This is present in the dimer form. This immunoglobulin gets cleaved into the Fab and the Fc because of IgA protease, and no longer it is able to bind to the streptococci. The organism is present as a normal flora of the children and the adult, and there it does not cause the infection, but these individuals, they are the asymptomatic carriers. They can shed the bacteria in the aerosols in the environment. When these aerosols, they are picked by the healthy person, they may get the disease depending upon their immune status and depending upon the presence of some other primary pathogen. In the case of an individual, the organism is present in nasopharynx as the normal microflora, but when there is some impairment in the immune system, it can reach into the lower tract and may cause the infection. The diseases which are caused by S. pneumoniae are classified into non-invasive, sinusitis, otitis media, pneumonia. In invasive diseases, there is bacteremia, meningitis, endocarditis, peritonitis, septic arthritis, appendicitis, salpingitis, and the soft tissue infections. MOPS stands for meningitis, otitis media, pneumonia, and sinusitis. The lobar pneumonia, bronchopneumonia, and chronic bronchitis. These are the diseases present in the lungs. Lobar pneumonia when either of the lobes are infected. Bronchopneumonia are the diffuse patches of the pneumonia. Chronic bronchitis when there is the infiltration and the air pathways, they get clogged. They occur mostly in the debilitated patient. Meningitis when the bacteria crosses the blood-brain barrier. In suppurative lesion, there is peritonitis, arthritis, appendicitis, and the infections of soft tissues. The lab diagnosis of pneumococcal infection. The clinical samples can be nasopharyngeal swabs when we are looking for the carriers. There can be the blood, pus, sputum, and the cerebrospinal fluid collected from the patient. The first approach is the staining, in which number of staining is done. In gram staining, if there are gram positive cocci in pairs, lanceolate appearance, then that indicates pneumococcus. Further, the capsule staining can be done by the negative staining method. The India ink is used. The electron microscopic preparations are usually carried out to study the capsule. Fluorescent staining uses the fluorescent dye. Kolling reaction is a characteristic reaction for the S. pneumoniae. It was first of all described by Neufeld. It can be carried for the S. pneumoniae culture, or it can also be carried for the sputum sample. On a glass slide, the culture of the sputum sample is taken, to which a drop of antiserum and then the methylene blue are added. In the presence of antiserum, the capsule becomes sharp, and this is the positive Kolling reaction. This shows the gram staining of S. pneumoniae, the fluorescent staining of the S. pneumoniae. Among the culture methods, the culture is carried out on the blood agar. There is alpha hemolysis. The colonies, they are characteristically bisoluble, autotrophin sensitive. If there is a positive Kolling reaction, we can see in this figure, there is the capsule around the cocci and here the capsule it becomes swollen when the homologous antiserum is added to it. The clinical material can also be inoculated into the mouse where it shows peritonitis. The antigen triple S can be detected by the precipitation or the latex agglutination test. There are two biomarkers, the CRP and procalcitonin, which can be detected by the test. The molecular methods, specific gene segments, they are detected using the PCR-based method. For treatment, the antibiotics are beta-lactam, aminoglycosides and fluoroquinolones. Number of pneumococcal vaccines are available. PPV stands for the pneumococcal polysaccharide vaccine, which is prepared from different 23 capsule types. PCV is the pneumococcal conjugate vaccine having the 13 common capsule types, which is conjugated to a protein. The vaccines are given to the children during the first or second year and can also be given to the aged individuals. For the prevention of pneumonia, World Pneumonia Day celebrated 2nd November each year. There are organizations like PACE and PATH who are working together for the pneumococcal vaccines. They are increasing the awareness and trying to make the vaccines available globally. In addition to this vaccine, the good hygiene, hand washing, screening and treatment of asymptomatic carriers can reduce the cases of pneumonia due to Streptococcus pneumoniae. Now at the end, I am giving you a tip. This is a memory tip. Hope using this tip, you can remember this bacteria well. This picture is giving all the unique characteristics of the bacteria, starting from its morphology, its antigen, the distinct colon test, the vaccines, and its predilection in the sickle cell anemia children, the diseases which are caused, MOPS. I hope you will better understand this bacteria. Thank you very much.